Welcome to Hybus News. My name is Suresh Kochar. The UN Security Council defeated a Russian resolution on Friday to commemorate the 20th anniversary of a UN measure demanding equal participation for women in activities promoting global peace, with opponents objecting to its failure to adequately address the human rights and the key role of civil society in pushing for a gender equality. The email vote on resolution was 5-0, with 10 countries abstaining, far less than the minimum 9 yes votes required for adoption. The Russian draft was supported by Russia, China, Vietnam, Indonesia, and South Africa. The countries that abstained include United States, United Kingdom, France, Belgium, Dominican Republic, Germany, Estonia, Niger, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and Tunisia also. Opponents said that the Russian draft weakened after the initial UN resolution adopted in 2009 and 9 follow-up resolutions which Russia strongly denied. Germany's UN ambassador, Christoph Hüsten, said in his calls for strong language in a human rights foundation for all resolutions and for the adequate reflection of the critical role of the civil society, women peace builders and human rights defenders in implementing the measures were not reflected in the Russian draft. What is needed is action and implementation, he said, not mere words. U.S. Ambassador Kelly Craft said that the Trump administration and other countries that abstained were protecting the women, peace and security agenda from an attack by Russia and China, which contributed to the draft resolution. She said that the draft resolution was designed to undermine and reverse the progress in the past 20 years, and it is evident that our Russian and Chinese colleagues do not believe that women should be fully empowered to prevent conflict or sit at the table to pursue peace and reconciliation. Russia's UN ambassador, Vasily Nebenzia, said that the current Security Council president told a news conference after announcing the vote that the defeated draft did reaffirm and urge implementation of all 10 previous resolutions. He dismissed claims that it was a step back or a watered down, as was not true. Civil society, human rights were all there, he said. We are for the civil society and human rights. To accuse us that we are trying to strike out a reference to at least being best is unworthy. Civil society and human rights are mentioned in the defeated resolution's introductory paragraphs, but not in the binding operative paragraphs. They were in the operative paragraphs in the earlier draft, but diplomats said they were dropped at China's insistence. The Russian resolution would have commemorated the 20th anniversary of the initial Women, Peace and Security resolution and noted with deep concern persistent barriers to its implementation. At a council meeting on Thursday commemorating the anniversary, the head of the UN agency promoting gender equality said the resolution's demand for equal participation for women in peace negotiation has failed. Women still remain systematically excluded from talks to end conflict where men make decisions affecting their lives. UN Women's Executive Director Phumile Mlambo-Nuka said that despite some good initiative, the peace negotiations from 1992 to 2019, only 13% of the negotiators or 6% of the mediators and 6% of the signatories to the peace agreement were women. Nuka also said that the negotiations elevated the empowered actors that have fueled the violence. Instead of empowering women and others who are peace builders and women who were either confined to informal progress or relegated to the role of spectators, UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres reiterated the Council's that gender equality is the first and foremost a question of power, and wherever we look, power structures are dominated by men, starting at the top where women lead with only 7% of the countries. Britain's acting UN ambassador, Jonathan Allen, said after the vote that the UK had widely shared the view that the Russian draft lacked sufficient language on the implementation of women's human rights and the protection of the civil society. The adoption of this text would have undermined the significant achievements made in this critical agenda and the enduring efforts of so many women rights activists, Allen added. Thank you for watching.